What we're gonna be doing is doing the carousel tent, and this was my test. As you can see, the yellow flag should have been under the trim, so this was my test. But essentially, this is how your trim is going. I'm sorry, this is how your tent is gonna come out once you cut it. You are going to cut it, and I will give you the dimensions on how I did it.
Okay, so as you can see, this is how the file comes out. And what I did, I stretched the top of the tent as much as I could to fit into my 12 by 12 mat. And the dimensions came to 11.841 times 11.19 height. Then the trim of the carousel, I only use the trim portion. There's a circle that comes out. I just deleted it. And basically, the whole thing, this portion comes to 10.739 wide by 5.262 wide. And it's the same thing at the bottom one. Then the base circle for the big circle. At the base, it was like 9.9, so it can cover entirely the styrofoam. The center of the carousel comes into two pieces. I mean, I'm sorry, the file comes with basically only like the bottom portion. So essentially, what I did is I just manipulated the file to make tabs to go up on top and at the bottom. So then the machine basically scores it and puts it together. I welded everything so it comes out like that. And then the little trim, I just fit all the banners as much as I could. But if you have an idea, basically the banners are going to be cut at 4.465 wide by 7.93 tall. The little triangles are going to come at 2.36 wide by 4.651 tall. So that's how you're going to cut your files.
The file is going to come out cut like this. I use my C6 Eclipse to do this, and as you can see, it comes nicely scored. And the top circle that I use, I've put the trim to cover the white styrofoam so it doesn't show up obviously when you put your tent on it. So the next thing we're gonna be doing is gluing the top portion to my base, to the top circle. And the top circle is 6 inches. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to adhere my top of the tent into my top styrofoam circle. My top styrofoam circle is actually 8 inches. So the dimensions that I gave you earlier will fit this. And what I'm doing is I am gluing the paper to the styrofoam with hot glue, and I'm only doing half of the circle at a time to ensure that I get it properly. And as you can see, you have to work quickly because the hot glue dries quite fast. So make sure that your hot glue gun, is pretty hot, and that you work quickly with this. So right now what I'm doing is I'm adjusting the rest of the tabs to glue it in there. And I'm just squeezing the glue into the tabs. Continue putting the glue all the way around until you have finished the entire rim. And the machine, the Eclipse, does a really nice job in scoring your paper and you know, cutting the tabs with really clean lines. I really love my Eclipse. I know I told you guys this before, but it's a great machine. So what I'm doing is essentially finishing up this thing. If you have little webs, just clean them up as you go so they don't show up on your final product. I'm almost done in here. And the paper is flexible. Now, this is an 80-pound paper, so it's pretty thick, and it gives way to work well with hot glue and the styrofoam. So that's how your top is going to turn out. And next thing you do is just you know, continue into the decorating part of the project.
So basically, after you put the circle with the trim, the file, the SVG cut file, comes with the trim on the tent and the little bags, I'm sorry, the little sections for the banner to create the rainbow effect. So basically, you know, you glue them together and then you do that. Now for my poles, what you can see is I use paper straws. And these paper straws are pretty popular now. You can find them online. I actually have some for sale. Not this color, but I have other colors. If you're interested, let me know. And then on the center, what I did, the SVG file comes as a box. So basically, when you get Mary's box, I mean Mary's file, this actually is a box. And then what I did for the middle of the carousel, I basically what I did is I just cut the exterior, which is supposed to form a box. I made it a little smaller and a little taller, okay? So to fit the length of my straws. And then what I did is I glue the tabs down here. And then I don't know if you can see, but I kind of put like a little shim up there. It's kind of hard to see, but I put some paper shims. Then what I did is I center it in the middle of the circle, right? So basically you just got to take a ruler and measure your bottom circle. My circle at the bottom is 9 inches, and this is a styrofoam circle. And I essentially just use my Eclipse to cut and map, to fit the 9-inch circle. And then what I did is I cut a 1-inch strip of 12 by 12 paper just to go around the entire rim of the circle to hide the foam. And then finally, I have these little felt animals. They are on my store. You can buy them. Right now I only have the lions, but I had some like the zebra and then the little tiger and then the little monkey. Another alternative to this is if you have the Create a Critter cartridge from Cricut, you can cut the animals from that. Now these ones are basically just sequins. You can get this probably at your local craft store. And I added this because carousels usually have mirrors. You can add mirrors if you want to make it more authentic, but I didn't want to go through the expense and to buy the mirrors and having to decorate them. So I just put these to give it a little more color, and that's how my centerpieces were done. You will see in my file, in my blog, the link to the SVG cuts, and I will tell you the files that I bought from them, and they are the Summer Carnival, I believe, but I will put a link on my blog. So that's how the centerpieces were done. If you have any questions, please email me and I'll be more than happy to answer you back. Until next time, happy crafting!